Yesterday we did the second Hitman movie. It wasn't really that good. Except for like a few small little tidbits. Today, we are continuing an adventure with John Wick 2! This is like one of three we are doing today. Can you hear it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yelp. Okay.
Yelp, master.
So, hey, look, it's like that roller coaster even more so.
Which one?
The one that you went on.
I would reply Rocket.
Yeah. That was actually crazy, but fun. Mm-hmm. Ah, Nebraska. So much corn to a shuck. You have to watch a certain YouTube video to get that joke. That's saying which one? Mm-hmm. Look at those neon colors. This is how you use lighting properly. Hey, Ben Corbin's in. Mm-hmm. It'd be hilarious if he just gets out now. And he's out. No, he's dead. He almost went over. Is this gonna be like the first one where we are pretty much at the end of the movie? Apparently, this one and the sequel got better reception than the first one, which only was great news because it had like an 84.
Mm-hmm.
So that must be good news. Corbin's out.
Wow. We just both noticed that.
Well, I mean, I'm not the one looking at the TV.
The Tonka, and I still have...
That's the, Native American what guy? Yeah, it is.
You still have 9 more guys. Well, 8 more guys until I come out.
Oh, there goes whoever that guy is.
Chad Gable.
Oh, was that Gable who got out?
Yeah.
Damn.
Well, Bo Dallas is now the new Drew McIntyre.
And Gable got out and...
Styles.
What? Damn!
That's CPUs for you.
That's what I hate about this game.
Also, it's way more easy to animate people in these games now.
Which is stupid.
That's things that you like that you can do it like
well,
that.
I like eliminating guys easily, but I don't like CPUs to eliminate guys easy.
That means you don't get that many guys to eliminate when you come out. There's a double-edged sword to everything.
Man, Dumbass is lucky to still be in this bitch.
Yeah, he's apparently in real estate with Liv Morgan now.
Hmm.
And Liv Morgan.
Oh, freaking... Okay, I think he's out here.
If he doesn't, I'll be amazed.
Yeah, with how hurt he is. Yep, he's out. Wow, it's only English and Tom.
And now the field has gone down to 2 again.
Mm-hmm.
Dude!
Mm-hmm.
What does that look like?
Yeah. What the hell's his name?
Do I say who I thought it looked like?
A Bootsy.
Yes! Exactly. Thank you.
I know who you texted him. Oh, I think that is.
Yeah, I'm looking it up. I'm looking it up.
What year was this movie?
2007, yeah.
Abraham Tarasov, that's him. Yeah, that's him.
I got this.
Yeah, that's Peter Stormare, that's him. That's him. Yeah, that's him.
Wow! What are the odds?
Yeah, that's him, you can tell. Edge came out.
Funny coincidence, right?
Mm-hmm.
I just see his face.
I was thinking the same thing. I was gonna say he looks like a brute.
Yeah, I just see his face.
No, I was trying to think. What the hell is his face again? I couldn't remember his name.
He's the main villain. I don't complain. Right?
Mm.
Of course, he won't be better than he was on Prison Break. He was perfect on Prison Break.
Mm-hmm. I assume you mean no problem.
Yeah.
Oh, there goes English.
Just like teabag.
Tonka with a couple of eliminations.
He was better in Prison Break than he was in Hitman.
You seem to get the fact that FBI shuts down at 5 o'clock, pretty.
Okay, can I say this right now? I don't know why.
Behold the villain. Oh, there goes Tatanka.
When you see 47 in this picture, it looks a little different from what he does in the movie.
Mm-hmm. It's probably just the lighting. Gold dust. And Edge already almost has his signature. Damn. Boom.
I think he ever said that on Prison Break.
Nope. I assume you mean no problem?
Look, he has 5 a.m. You see that?
Never question his will. Hey.
What?
Never question his will.
And this is already better than the
Edge
Hitman.
Now has his signature. But he doesn't.
Who does that guy with the mustache remind me of?
I'll punch him once, Edge. And you couldn't. You just have to keep bringing him up. Nimrod.
You know who this is?
Mm.
It's John Wick, obviously.
Oh, now he has a signature.
Execution?
That's a cigarette.
He lost his signature, I would have laughed.
Wow, Goldust has almost the same amount of energy that Edge has.
Yet Edge already has a finisher.
And Edge already has more has more energy than Goldust.
You have my car. Hang up. That's what they call John Wick, in case you don't remember from the first movie, which we saw about a week ago.
I don't remember that.
Exactly.
Yeah! I just love Shestlau. Yeah. Wow, Finn Balor. Virgo Divot. That's his name. That's a weird-ass name. I'm starting to think that his parents were freaking potato farmers, and they named him after a freaking fungus.
That's just insulting.
Fergal, that just sounds like a freaking, damn, Edge just kicked him straight in the face. That sounds like a freaking fungus to me.
He hasn't even used his signature yet.
He's getting close to having...
You know, this Edge model is severely outdated. But of course...
Just do a Jordan Penn look.
Yeah, which is...
Wow, he's gonna have his... Yep, he has his finisher now.
There's the signature.
And he's already 49%. He's already halfway to another sig.
This is John. Oh!
Yay! Oh, okay, that was funny.
What?
Edge was showboating and Finn Balor Irish whipped gold dust into him. Edge deserved that.
You know, there is a way. I want to show you this when we're done, but there's someone out there that you can do two finishers to. You can't do it. You need to have two guys in the ring at once, and it gets really hard if it's 2-on-1.
Oh,
I see.
Who is it, like, double F5?
Yeah, double AA. It used to be a double shell sock.
I was gonna say a double ryback finisher. Yeah, I forgot his finisher name.
That sucks!
You suck up. Dude, here comes Kevin Nash. Edge results.
John Wick 4 and 5 was going to shoot back-to-back like Fast 10's doing, but they decided not to do it.
Are they doing it?
What?
Like a 4 and 5 movie.
Yeah?
They're not doing it
back-to-back, though. It's like, I think Infinity War and Endgame were back-to-back in filming.
Yeah, like, let's say, finished one. They took like a week break or some shit like that, then started getting them. For real. Like, every time I saw a promo for Endgame, it would be where they're getting ready to go get, all the stones.
Yeah, because that was, like, the big vocal point.
Up there goes Balor! Edge.
That wasn't...
Man.
Wait, he used his finisher?
Must have. Yeah, that makes sense, actually, yeah.
Hmm.
Man, I still have, what, 4, 5, 6, I still have 3 more guys for me. I'm an impatient bastard.
Why, you lousy, big-nosed bastard?
So, Deb, you're like a naughty party girl, huh? No, Frank.
Deborah.
Oh, there goes Blowins. Wow! Blowins! He literally just came in, and there goes Edge.
Goldust?
How the hell are these two still standing out of everyone?
He's Goldust. He does whatever he wants.
Yeah, well, I would have thought Edge and Kevin Owens would have lasted longer than...
What do you expect? The boys of Cody Rhodes would bury people. And no, I won't take that back.
You will come down to Cobb County.
Do you remember that in Big Boss Man's theme song?
No, because I didn't just hear it last night. You know, this is 2 hours.
Oh, funny news. Apparently there's a Britt Baker action figure that's being released of blood and
guts. And Ziggler came in and just got out.
Jesus. What, did you see Elite 92? Damn, they changed the packaging up. Yeah, they changed the packaging up for the figures.
Here's, let me see.
Burnt Fiend.
Let me see it. Is this the new series?
The newest Elite, yeah. You don't want that Fiend, don't you?
That is hilarious. That was
six. Wow. Gonna take like 6 months to see them.
There's a chair variant of the Adam Cole one. Hey, of course they'll be in the same series together.
Giggle. Hey, giggle.
Abuti's time in this movie might be over.
Already?
Yeah. He doesn't look older than he did back in Prison Break. And this is like 10 years after he was on Prison Break.
Yeah, 10 years older.
How old was he when Prison Break first premiered?
I think he's like... Let me see how old he is. I mean, he's in his late 60s now, so he was...
He doesn't look 60!
He was in his early 50s when Prison Break hit. Well, he's Swedish, so Swedes age.
Wait, is he gonna die or is he gonna leave him? He's leaving him! I would say he got poisoned, but I didn't see him falling down, so I'm not saying he was poisoned, so they should, mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. And now into the movie. Ooh, look at this. Okay, that just looks weird.
And I just realized Goldust was out.
And Kevin Nash might get Dean Ambrose out. Kevin, oh wow, surprising. Kevin Nash burying people. It reminds me of WCW. Mm-hmm.
Man, how easy is this match going to be when I get in?
Super easy.
I know.
Unless you really screw up and get him in somehow. Do you miss the final two and someone eliminates you because they kill you by the look of
it? I'm going to be so goddamn pissed.
I will laugh my ass off.
Now, here comes D-Bry, though, so I'm going to be entering the match with a bunch of really high-rated guys, of course.
And none of them are with WWE.
That's right. Are all of them with AEW?
Kevin Nash has it.
Oh, he's no one.
I think he's technically a legend.
Well, I already know that Dean Assholes, John Moxley, and Daniel Bryan is Bryan Danielson. That's kind of funny how his WWE name is the reverse of his
name. People say that you are wrong if you call them Dean Ambrose or Dean Bryan now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, kids can call them whatever they want from what they remember.
Dean, that's what you get for showboating on the top rope.
Right. People remember them. If you look at people, Daniel Bryan now, who do you think they're going to call him? Bryan Danielson or Daniel Bryan?
I mean, really, either or. I mean, you can call him by his WWE name or his real name.
Yeah, but people, he's more known for his WWE name now.
Yeah. I mean, I'd say...
It's a dog from the first
when it comes to John Moxley, it's probably better if you call him John Moxley or Jonathan Good.
Or that Mox?
That is a pretty funny last name, though, Good. Oh, that's... Ooh.
You remember when he was on Total Divas?
Yeah, and someone took his hat, and he's like, not today. He freaking jumps over and ran after him.
Yeah.
That's pretty funny. Hey, here comes Abortion.
And you're going to get out in 5 seconds.
What did you say, Mitch?
You're going to get out in 5 seconds when you get in.
Oh, looks like...
Yeah, and this burial tour. You want to be careful. He has a finish shot. Oh, look at that good doggy. So you know how he came out of a Tyman in the first movie?
Yeah.
He's going back into a Tyman in this one.
Mm-hmm. Man, I'm really starting to annoy us because these two won't get the hell out of my way.
And you almost have a finisher.
Huh?
You almost have a finisher.
Damn!
Look at you go.
I know, right?
Oh my god!
Huh?
John Moxley and Bryan Danielson are currently in a storyline in AEW. Mm-hmm.
Alright, get out
irony.
Of here.
That's irony right there, because you didn't even decide what they come out at.
Alright, bye Kevin Nash.
Finally, the burial tour's over.
Hey, I got an easy guy. Oh, hell no. Oh, screw you, Brian, you cocksucker.
You did this! That is still one of my favorite Randy Orton responses to a man.
No.
I know Keanu Reeves from The Matrix, and we already did this last week, so...
Oh, you pencil-necked ass!
Did he taunt you?
No, he was just pissing me off.
Oh, no!
What do I do with the suplex again?
X, left on the top of X. Brian already took care of it.
Oh, you douchebag.
Just give me my least favorite John Wick movie. Look at the fifth person listed or credited.
That's weird. Oh,
no! Lawrence Fishburne. Hey, he was in, he was also in The Matrix.
Screw you, D-Bry.
Man of Steel, Batman v Superman, Ant-Man and the Wasp. I knew him.
Mm-hmm. Oh. You get.
Peter Stormare was into the Lost World Jurassic Park, which is a
screw you, Enzo, you cocksucker. Dickhead. I'm coming for you, Enzo, you little Boom! Get your ass.
Can you calm down, please? I'm trying to say some information here. He played the Dracula in the Batman vs. Dracula. That's a weird
one. Now, you know what? I ain't. No. Piss off, Dean, you dick.
I didn't know that. Well, add that to a list of Prison Break actors that appeared on an Arrowverse show. This is your chance to escape because no one else is around. Abruzzi was on Arrow as two different was on Arrow for two episodes. That still counts. You may want to you want to be careful of who you eliminate.
Oh, shove it up your ass, Jason Jordan, dickhead.
Yeah, you can do your signature any time once you get enough stamina.
Like, really, these assholes are... There's too many guys in here. We can go. Finally someone at.
Who got out?
Apollo Crews. Screw you, Dean, you douche.
Sucre is the first actor or actress that was in Prison Break to not be in the Arrowverse.
You're gonna come for me, aren't you, you douchebag? Yeah, screw you.
You could come for Dean Ambrose, too. Wow.
No.
Back away, just back away, just let them fight. Just stay in the corner and choose your opponent wisely. You can eliminate anyone you want, save it. Because you go over the top rope again, you are done, okay?
Probably.
So just stop, don't do anything, just let them fight it out. Dean Ambrose might be out. Go for blind.
You, Dean.
Just go for it. They'll fight each other. Brian. What was that, Jordan?
Yeah, go after each other, douchebags.
Daniel Bryan can eliminate Jason Jordan at any time, so you just wait and see. If Brian uses his finisher, that'd be good. Do you use the audio recovery?
Yeah, plus.
Don't get involved, because you can't counter. This isn't good.
Come on.
That, you got involved. That was more than you.
Yeah, shut up. Shut up, man. Yes! Well, it looks like you're screwed, Jason.
Unless he somehow counts the corner finisher. And there goes Don Rick's house.
You're dead.
In the first movie, he got lost his car, his wife, and his dog. In this movie, he's losing his house.
I Alright, let's end this shit.
You serve taunt at first, don't come to stamina. You barely survived.
Asshole.
You barely survived.
I know, right?
Yeah, screw you too, Daniel.
You're the one who got in between us.
Shut up, Meg.
You shut up, Meg.
I'll be right back. I'm hungry.
Damn, yeah.
See you, Johnny. What?
Yeah.
What? Jonathan. His name is John Wick, but it's not for Jonathan Wick.
Mm-hmm.
Can you guess who that Skippy Ball is? Yes. You know him.
Relic?
Yeah. Mm. I didn't know that until just now.
What's that from?
Venom. He has a cameo in Venom. Is that funny? Mm. So they did this on purpose. Paul Kellerman's actor.
Paul Adelstein?
He appeared in 2003 in an episode of SVU.
Oh, nice.
Episode, season 4, episode 14.
Mm-hmm.
You know what his character's name is?
Mm.
Stephen Kellerman. And it's spelled the exact same way as Paul Kellerman. They did that on purpose. Also, Bellick's actor has played more than one Batman villain.
Mm.
He voiced Black Mask, Harvey Dent. He was a prison guard in The Dark Knight Rises. He was Warden. So that's even funny. And then he also appeared in a Batman TV show as Wayland Jones or Killer Croc.
Mm.
So he's voiced three Batman villains. He also played a character in Hitman Blood Money.
Nice.
What is these cast, this cast of characters? This is hilarious. I don't remember Beware the Batman. I don't remember Beware the Batman. Because it only had one season. Yeah, because you're dicking around doing jack off. Oh, that's what you're doing.
Last man standing.
Oh, you better be careful.
One.
You can lose just like that.
No, no. Damn it, Leslie, get up, you fool. Stop being a fool.
I'm liking this movie so
far. Mm-hmm. Oh, you dick.
Wow. Hey, Mafia. So he has an ego the size of his head that he can do better than her. So he wants his sister dead so he can take her seat. Wow, this guy's a terrible. This is guy's brother of the year, right?
Mm-hmm.
You still love her, yet you still want to kill her. He doesn't want anybody. He wants you.
What's this? Ah, you can't go down there, can you?
What?
Can you use these?
Those? No. This aesthetic effect. Actually, go towards the small one.
I know it's bullshit.
And why did we stall it?
I clicked on backstage. We're fighting backstage, see?
Oh! You can go backstage and that's been standing match?
Mm-hmm. So I can try and do that with the table?
What?
I can do that with the table.
I think so. Do you know how you put that AJ Styles up to the announce table?
Mm-hmm.
Do the same with Roman. X. R2. Hold R2. No, he's a super suplex. Alright, hold R2
mm-hmm.
and drag him over towards the table.
No? R2.
Yes. And then they'll go the other way, towards the table. Whoa, okay. He just twisted his bike. Keep doing it. Do it again. Get into the middle of the table. No, wrong way. There you go.
Literally, I can't move it.
Alright, can you pick him up and I'll strip him? Must be some way you can do this. Alright, if you can somehow suplex him the other way. Alright, suplex him if you can. Oh, there you go, you might have it.
Nope.
Nope. I don't know what to do. Do you want me to try it or no?
No.
I don't know why you can't do it. It's stupid. Are you for the Pope? This guy's on my foot then. I love this guy already, you know why? John Rick isn't here for the Pope? Okay, he'll help him out. Is that funny?
Uh-huh.
If Roman Reigns gets up this F5 his ass. Yeah, tomorrow's technically the next reaction's only an hour and a half. SpongeBob.
God damn it, Roman! I have to write what I wanted you.
What are you doing on the wall, my boy? Yeah, you know, just hanging around. Boo!
Stop Irish whipping him that way.
Stop this. Regain your stamina and just finish him. Oh, God.
I'll finish him when I want to finish him.
Yeah, and then when you lose, you're going to be complaining about how it's bored. Even though it's your fault for the fact that you kept it going. Dude, this is way better than the Hitman movies. Tell me why. Of course, in Hitman's defense, they're trying to follow a game series, but they do it terribly. Oh, you got it. Oh, what was this being a bully now? Yeah, you're not gonna be able to put him through that table.
Ooh, I almost did.
Okay, go behind him. Pick him up again. Yeah, okay, just pick him up and try and do it again. There you go.
Yes!
There you go, you finally did it.
Finally.
That's challenge classic. Dessert. Custom order.
And he's purple.
If he gets up, I'll be surprised. Oh, who's in that interview? I think it's Xavier.
Looks like him. I'm just walking.
If you want towards him, they won. Watch. Go closer to him. Go closer to him. See? But we haven't got back up.
How?
Did you use both finishers?
Yep.
Sami Zayn. And he's going running.
Yep, there goes Nikki running. You know who this chick is.
There's a weird steel chair. I didn't know you could do that.
I didn't know this backstage area was this extensive.
Oh, it was. I knew that. I played this game before. Mm-hmm. You should watch more of this. This is actually fun. They spent like literally 7 minutes just him going for weapons, and that's a good thing. It's hilarious. Mm. He's so calm about it, too. John Wick is...
Alright, time to finish your ass, Roman.
He's still gonna get back up. For some reason, Roman Reigns has the biggest overall, and no matter how many finishers he takes, he constantly gets back up. I did like 5 finishers to him when he was already in the red, and he constantly kicked out. Mm-hmm. Don't ask me how. Let's stay there now, don't do anything.
No, I'm walking away.
This is the end of the backstage area.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. Last
Bro,
second!
Bullshit.
Last second! He has a spear! Right to the wall.
That's
See what I mean? How Roman is constantly just getting back up? The more damage you take, the harder it will be to get back up. Now, let's get a soundtrack, man.
Wow, I didn't know there was a bunch of cables here.
I don't know if you can put him through those or not. Hey, buddy, here he comes. And he just speared you mid-move.
Mm-hmm.
I would have laughed if that happened. It's a spear out of nowhere!
And he's... Okay, he's gray.
One more F5 to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Either that or he's just cheating now.
Oh, screw you.
He has another signature and a finisher. Okay, come on, that was worth it.
How did I not get... Okay, now give me my sin.
Went into the trash can. Stop. Wait, now. Oh, he will call it just in time. That probably wasn't the smartest move.
Yeah.
Stop. Wait for your stamina to have more than enough. Okay, now do it. If you charged the finisher, you wouldn't need to press another button.
Mm.
And if he gets back up, you know what this means?
Mm.
You can get 5 stars then.
Mm.
If he gets back up, then this is the end of the game. Roman Reigns is just, you can't beat him.
Mm.
The CPU difficulty, then this. How many times have you F5'd him now?
Three or 4.
Exactly, and he's still getting up. 2, 1, and he's getting up.
Mm-mm.
Nope, there it is. Die. This is egotistical. Who needs a bathroom this big?
I'll keep it, please.
You have to wait a minute. I don't know. But no. And Dominic's in the middle now. Smooth. That's a smooth transition. 1 second he's not.
The next he's there.
Control lock. Always. No, no.
I know, no.
Okay, I'm taking it out. Once it out,
I'll be back, Papa.
You are a pain in the ass. Oh, no.
What did she do?
That's a knife. That's a knife. Oh, my God.
What?
I was trying to keep it discreet.
Okay.
You know, I was going to say when you came in. John is a lucky man.
You give a damn that she's naked.
Now, I'm pissed that you ruined the joke I was going to say.
Oh, poor baby.
I'm pretty sure that would lead to an infection.
I have a bladder infection.
What is this movie now?
Cancun.
It's in a pool of blood now. Oh, I think she's about to die. Yep. There it goes.
Trash
can. Oh, you're gonna
have spit on
there? There's also trash bag in it, though. So what's the second half of this movie gonna be about? Oh, no, Kidman 3 copied John Wick. Look at that. Because he's out of wave. It's like a giant party with music. Look at this. Seven is in a wave. Oh, he knows exactly what's on, Dad. It does part of the show. At this point, I don't think it's part of the show now. Yeah, everyone starts to realize that this is real.
Oh yeah, female affection.
You ever went there to, you know, buy drugs?
He shot a guy, used him as a shield, and then threw the guy off to shoot the next guy.
Si. Italia. And then freaking Sam starts speaking in freaking Italian.
I bet the chicken cottage. Amy was the one who threw it out.
I bet the chicken cottage. Amy was the one who threw it out.
What?
I like how I was like, don't start with me.
Yeah.
Don't start with me, biscuit blocker.
You know what episode goes between the miles? Wallpaper.
Which one's that?
The one where Marine Flint drives through Wayne Devil.
Oh, yeah.
Wayne's kicking them out because he's upset. And what's Devil doing? He's telling him to reconsider it.
Mm. Hey, you know, I think that looks like a... Holy crap! I do like how he never noticed. I like how he would always stare in amazement.
I like how the joke is, it's like, oh, he knows what it is, and that's why he's staring at it. He did it!
Yeah.
It's at the very end.
Yeah, but his reaction was just the best.
That's how you set up a joke. You make the audience think they know the joke, and then, nope, it's another joke entirely. Someday you're gonna turn around, and I'm not gonna be here anymore.
Not today.
Ah! I like how you can see Wallet knew what Wayman was about to do.
Yeah. Bro, let's be honest. Frank would throw a freaking party today. Frank's gonna throw a freaking party the day that happens.
No. What's he gonna get for food then?
Nah, that's true. Do you ever want to eat again? I'm a crazy old man who lies.
Oh, no. No, no.
Ah!
Maybe that is.
Huh.
Who was?
Oh. The fact that he isn't shot is a goddamn miracle.
47 that gets shot to the very end of the last segment we watched.
That's true, and he didn't get shot at all in the first one.
Exactly! This is more realistic. Because he's actually gotten
shot. A bunch of different teams.
He's actually John Wickhill has actually gotten hit. The more the second Hitman movie went on, the more it just got frustrating.
Yeah.
If they said that Agent 90 had the ability to actually have like advanced senses, like from the beginning, then at least it would explain how she kept having these visions of 47, because you know what that looked like she was having?
Mm.
She was seeing him coming ahead of time. It's like, she's predicting the future! It was stupid. I did wish we had an actual movie of the two being brother and sister. That would have been funny.
Mm.
I just got it now. Him saving that whole father was so the whole father can blow himself up and the guy wants to continue the agent project.
Mm-hmm.
Because the guy that wants to continue it was his target.
And so was his father. So was her father, I think.
That's actually... I actually didn't fully realize that at first. Wait, so he put a bomb or something in an inhaler?
Mm-hmm.
That is weird. But considering the Joker put a bomb in a guy's stomach and sent him to the police station to blow up, I can't really complain about over the top. That actually happened in The Dark Knight. Again, he thinks his Joker is a gift. You ready? Okay, I can't see much in this hallway. Maybe a little bit more lights, boys. And he's dead. Oh my god, that was on the couch.
Oh no!
I know! So I have a question.
Yep.
Do you want to do this today, or do you want to flip it?
Doesn't matter. If you want to do the shorter one today.
Let's do the shorter one today, and then we can do the other one tomorrow.
Man, god damn it! That's what really grinds my gears.
I love how we had two Batwoman alumni in the movies. We had Dougie Scott and Hitman, and I have Ruby Rose and
Dougie Scott.
The main character of Hitman?
Technically a secondary one.
Well, he's the main cop though.
Yeah.
And he's the one hunting 47, so he's kind of the main character. You do know that Hitman Agent 47 isn't the sole main character. There's multiple main characters.
Mm-hmm.
The imposter guy, that's the target, he's a secondary character. Mm-hmm. Cheap shot. Considering you just cheap shot him like that. They keep talking, I love this.
Now I have to redo this, because I'm an idiot.
But we are. You know what makes this even better? There's no music.
Mm.
I think this guy's about to die.
Ooh,
nope.
That's
they both fell down the stairs.
Hey.
Dude. Ouch.
Look at me. Hey, look at me.
Intervention!
Just a boy.
I'm pretty sure one of them, they're either really hurt or one of them would be dead by now.
Just a boy!
How many stairs does this place have? Jesus! Amba! Break his arm! I'm saying, don't break his arm!
Oh!
You gotta see this.
What is it? What are your funds? Well, it's not pretty nice or so nasty. You make it play your five boss with five. Fuck you, Papa. I ain't no fat bastard. I'm the same specimen of a man.
Dude, please stop. I'm trying to pay attention to this. Oh my god. You know what this proves? John Wick isn't invincible.
Oh.
And that's a good thing, you know why? If your character's invincible, where's the threat? Like 47 can never get hurt. Yeah, he's never gonna get hurt. Where's the danger in him then? He's gonna go through every encounter fucking hit once being in danger of dying. I like how they were in the middle kicking each other's asses and then he's like this.
Mm-hmm.
Ha ha! This is so super violent.
Bourbon.
I'd say that.
Grazie, ciao.
Howl from Malcolm in the Middle is a sad, weak, pathetic little man.
Mm-hmm.
Who only cares about himself or Lois.
Oh, yeah, female fashion.
Now, he didn't give his son a birthday gift so he can get himself a poker table.
He's sad.
He said this to his kids at one point. For the next 12 hours, you boys are all going to be my slaves. And then the whole thing they built, he didn't want to do it with Lois anymore after she says he didn't believe in an afterlife.
Mm-hmm.
And the only reason...
Sandra, I'm going home!
Sire.
No!
The only reason that this fighting stopped, Lois had to swallow whole pride and admit that there was one, because how would it let it go?
Yeah.
He's a sad little man.
And he's a really same specimen.
I see why the boys are the way they are. Hal has no self-control with anything. Well, Lois has too much self-control.
Yeah. Because he's all hot-cha.
You know what I love? The episode...
Giggle.
The episode where Dewey's just smoking so many cigarettes. Hal promises that Dewey stops smoking, he would stop drinking coffee.
Mm-hmm.
At one point, Hal starts smoking it because the promise was he would stop drinking coffee.
But then Dewey starts drinking coffee.
Yeah, and so they're both having a dick mess of coffee.
Yeah.
And Lois comes in, and Hal just goes, he's drinking coffee.
Yeah.
Dumb.
I mean, really, it's worse that Dewey was smoking, let's be honest.
You know what's even worse than that, though?
How many cigarettes he had stashed?
Yeah! For God's sakes, you guys could have a nice house if you didn't spend all that money on cigarettes.
Or if he wasn't a douchebag to his boss.
That too, yeah.
No.
But I guess who has to pay the price for Hal being this most stupid person on planet Earth?
Other motherfucker in the world.
Exactly, then he has to try and guilt trip them later.
Mm-hmm.
When Ida was trying to sue them, they would have to pay out of their own pocket. Yeah, if they didn't have enough money, I know who's to blame for this. The person who has over 20,000 cigarettes.
Mm-hmm. If you're calling these that many damn cigs.
How? I do like Dewey. When he finds out how many there are, you could have sent me to a nice school with that money.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's got a point. How much money do you think goes into buying cigarettes that big? No, that much.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. Do you know why Ruby Rose isn't terrible in this movie?
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't need to act. And no, I'm not taking that back. I watched her on Batwoman, and she was the one actor/actress that was terrible. Willis Day played Kate Kane in season 2, and she had more personality. I don't know if that's because of the way they wrote the character, if that was that's how Ruby Rose acts. But right now, I'm going off of the second one. When I think of that phone, I just think of Logic Wars.
Mm-hmm.
You've seen of Greg, Logic, and their mom on the phone together. I like how when you can see Greg come on screen, you can see... Molly.
Mm-hmm.
When Greg comes on screen, you can just see Logic, just like...
Because
he doesn't know what Greg was going to say.
Shiza! Yeah, he's all like, Shiza.
I think your brother likes her!
And I'll go look at, like, what the
hell? And I'm just like, reminder! You can't call if you're dead.
I mean, let's be honest, Rowley's big ass probably deserved to be killed. And who else says that?
Do you know what makes the difference between Susan and Frank and Hal and us?
Mm-hmm.
Susan and Frank at least tried.
Mm-hmm.
Name one thing they did that was terrible.
Point.
Frank's not there much, but that's the whole point of the third movie. He said he wants to spend some more time with his kids. He has to try.
Mm-hmm.
Also, he's funny. Frank is actually funny. I stopped laughing. I stopped. Who's the laughter now? Me! I'm the laughiest laughter that's ever laughed. Ha ha! Ha! Ha!
I'm going to work on my battle diorama.
Buddy, stop.
I'm going downstairs to work on my battle diorama.
And Susie keeps closing the door on him. Hey.
Ooh, I'm late for work. Ooh, I'm late for work. Aye, honey.
At that point, they had to know he was doing it intensively. That's what makes it funny.
Mm-hmm.
You do know that Frank's idea or plan wasn't going to work in Logic Wars?
Yeah.
He's filming Logic Play.
Mm-hmm.
He's telling Greg about how the crowd is loving Susan dancing.
That is all you can hear him say.
That's true, but the camera's right in front of him.
Exploded diaper.
Oh, the lyrics would be better if the song title was better.
Mm-hmm.
You know what makes it even more sad?
Fading.
What makes it even more sad?
Huh.
Logic misspelled both loaded and diaper.
Mm-hmm.
He also misspelled sweetie as sweaty. How is a guy that stupid able to be so good at being bad? Right?
Mm-hmm.
The person that had him to kill his sister, he's that tried to kill John and stuff to type through that.
Mm-hmm.
So basically it's like Hitman, but a plot that you can follow better.
Mm-hmm. My boy.
There's four lads to put your face on the team today.
Huh?
They announced four legends for Chicken Chunk Jam. Booker T, Big Boss Man, Randy Savage, and China.
I wonder why Big Boss Man was announced for him.
If Jeff and Matt Hardy team up in AEW, you know this proves? Matt Hardy really can't do a character by himself without Jeff now.
Mm-hmm.
John Wick versus the one now. Hell yeah. Oh, stabbed with a pencil. You know how strong you have to be to do that? Oh, I think I'm. Oh, no, right to the ear. Please stop. Jesus Christ, movie. Wow. This is way more disturbing to watch than Hitman.
Hmm. Nah, poor fat guy. Damn!
He's dead?
Yeah. A shot like that to the head, he's dead or he's just at home.
You know that in the last 2 years, anyone that WWE has released?
Yeah.
So far, they haven't made that big of an impact, except like Zach walking off. Mm-hmm. Do you think that that's an issue and then see why they might have been released? No one's seeing this? This is a... Oh, Jesus. Okay, I cannot wait for this movie to be over now. He's stabbing people in places I don't want to see people get stabbed. People are just ignoring the fact that there's dead bodies there. You know what's actually impressive about that whole camera scene in The Incredibles?
What, Jerry Falwell?
It did catch Dash in the act.
Mm-hmm.
If you look close, you can see it move slightly.
Yeah, but, I mean...
But to the principal, it just looks like it's...
It's supposed to be 1960s gore, so, yeah.
Is that stuff around in 1960?
Cameras?
No, the way... Well, he had a TV and a VCR.
No, that was not...
Exactly! That's why saying in the 1960s doesn't really work.
Mm-hmm.
when you get to Incredibles 2, they have all this advanced tech. It's like, this is not 1960s. A motorcycle with a TV screen, a camera you can hook up to a suit. And they're fighting again. Oh! Careful, Johnny. Oh, oh, oh! Look at these boys go. It's just a job. Oh yeah, he's dead. You hear that? We're in close to the end of the movie. Oh, he's hiding now.
Damn, it's dark.
Hey man, you gotta cut it. That's awesome.
The Legend. Knew it. I heard I know that.
Because people call it, say that all the time. The man, the myth, the legend. People say that all the time. I was trying to get close, but thank you. And all bits of confusion. This movie's gonna end if you don't tell me this. How many times can you say John in the span of a minute?
You told me! Yuck! Here we go, boy!
It's the Johnny Wick.
Get it right. Look at the muscles. Show them, kid.
I won for most muscular pig.
Oink! Oh my God.
Damn, why? Look at those muscles. So big. That's so funny joke. Johnny. You like that? That's just... Let's fail, Wyatt. Mm-hmm. It says the reward for John Wick's head is $7 million.
Mm-hmm.
He gets 7 rounds.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's helping him instead of getting the bounty. Yeah, because he owed the guy that tried to kill him now.
Mm-hmm.
He killed the guy's sister as the favor, and now
mm-hmm.
the guy's trying to kill him. Because you haven't
he's
fought.
He's off.
You haven't fought him that much. Look to your time on this
one. Come on, boy, wizard. What? Off!
You were supposed to do that because at this point you were taking over the tree.
Alright, let's try to save this pen, bitches.
I'll be honest with you, I prefer finding Nemo over finding Dory,
mm-hmm.
but the characters in finding Dory are just as funny. But they're not as memorable as finding Nemo's. I mean, I'm sorry, the moment that we saw Bruce and fighting Nemo is right in my head.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, fighting Dory's not gonna be better than this one.
Because
mm-hmm. I don't remember seeing Bruce and fighting Dory.
Oh,
really
Bruce. On my honor.
Oh, he came to you.
Ha, eat it, bitch. Hey.
What?
I conceded another penalty, but hey, look. Save this one.
Oh, nice. Okay, there's so many of you, and you can't hit one guy. Did I get silence for a second before there's just more gunfire?
Oh my god. Another penalty given up, isn't it?
So have you seen tomorrow's movie?
Damn it.
Have you seen this?
Like once, I
think. And it was a long time ago. We're pretty much at the end of this movie, because we have credits too. And I mean, what else is there after he takes on the guy that put the bounty on him? I mean, if you take out the guy who put the bounty on you, who's gonna pay the bounty then if you get taken out? Right? Oh! He just did a mic!
Mm.
He sent the guy through the wall!
Mm.
If you don't watch Breaking Bad, you don't get it, but it's a funny joke. That whole scene is funny. It's trippy. What the hell? Yo, oh, this is like a Hall of Mirrors type thing.
Phil Foden. What? You seem to get the fact that the Ashford started at 5 o'clock, buddy.
Wrong movie. Yes, it was. You're the one who set the contract. You would pay the contract, though. No wife, no life. Apparently just struck 40, why? Tech Universal? It closed down recently.
Yeah, I know, like last month or something.
So we actually went right before the
game. I mean, it wasn't that special anyway.
It's been there for a long time.
Yeah, but it wasn't that special.
It was weird, I tell you, that the moving seats were just weird. Dude, this is so trippy. Dude, I'm starting to get confused and getting a small headache now.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this Hall of Mirrors. Ooh. So many blades in this movie. Oh my God. No, she does sign language in this movie. They actually tell you what she's saying. Like the text that comes up on screen, I actually like that. He's still alive!
Man, I see this game gives me no appreciation for the two penalties.
Okay, let's go already, please.
Kia Maruda! Get out of the water! Hey, guess what?
What?
Get out of the water!
So I think he's gonna lose his membership now.
Ooh.
Oh, he's a good boy.
Intervention! Just a boy.
What? Oh, we lost your home, man.
Tight job. That dog's like, alright, let's walk. I'll be honest with you, I have basically not watched any of this movie. Yeah, that's a bit. I've been too busy.
I've been watching all of your damn movies. That little good doggy. $14 million now? I mean, John did break the rules. Could you please stop? You may want to pay attention to some water. Ah! Everyone just looked at him!
Damn.
He's not being hunted.
Kill him all, Carl.
He knows he will, too. I don't hate this guy, you know why? The whole Winston had a rule for the hotel. You couldn't kill in a certain area, John killed in that area. He broke the rules. John and his dog against the ward. Here we go. This is like the very end of the movie.
What the hell is this?
A walk area?
What the hell is this?
John.
I thought that was freaking Marv.
John Wick is executing Nakano at the hotel. That's a bounty. In 1 hour, people are going to be hunting John Wick.
That's
for $14 million.
And that's the purpose of John Wick 3.
I believe so, yeah.
Why?
Because he killed a guy, and he was
supposed to. Nay, shite.
this is just like Hitman in a way now. Police 7 against the 1, look at that. And this is in 2017 too, I'm out of that. He's went out to one. His dog's running with him.
No, those are all of them after him.
I think so. They have to wait 1 hour, though.
Oh, but they're basically following him.
No. Maybe. I actually don't know. But the guy that had the part of the hotel, he told John he has 1 hour to one before the hunt for him begins. He's giving John that one courtesy. This music is really good. And that's how it ends.
Nice, my.
And I believe the third one does pick up where this one ends, because if it does end up the whole thing not going forward, it's just a big punch to the face. Mm. Well, I would ask you what you thought, but you weren't watching, so. John Wick 2 is better than the first one. I enjoyed it a lot better. Mm.
As I said, I'm not going to comment because I watched
The first one was great, but the second one improved on, like, the whole story.
I'll admit to you this, though. Do not ask me any, like, when it comes to, like, what happens in the next movie we're watching, because I have no idea. I don't remember what came of it.
Alright. And also, if you want to leave, if you want to make people excited for a sequel, you end it on a cliffhanger like that. Here's the thing. You want to make sure you're getting a sequel. You know why?
Why?
If this is if that was the last John Wick movie, that would be a big middle finger to audiences. So the whole world is hunting for $14 million and we don't find out what happens next. It's like if Infinity War happened but Endgame was never announced. What happens next? You never find out. That's just the end. That's not a good ending. Well, Some people probably know what we're doing, considering how I usually do reactions like this usually. But John Wick had 7 rounds for $7 million, and tomorrow we have we're doing something different, but it's also a sequel. It's gonna have a Predator. One that's an Apex. See you guys tomorrow for Winning Arguments!